Hello students, so now in this video we will discuss about the general characters of phylum Ascalmenses, right? So this is the fifth phylum we can consider, right? So Ascalmenses, the members belongs to Ascalmenses are called Ascalmenses only. So these are also commonly called roundworms. Yes, they are called roundworms. The members belongs to the Ascalmenses, phylum Ascalmenses are commonly called as round worms because body is cylindrical, tapering at ends, but it is appears like a cylindrical. When you take the cross section, it is circular body. It appears like a circular. For example, so you can consider the Ascaris. Okay, Ascaris body is somewhat cylindrical. Right, this is the Ascaris. And there is a structure called pineal setae, and we also observe that the lateral line, which is appears, which will decide the dorsal and ventral side, that is lateral line. Okay, lateral groove or lateral line is appeared here, lateral line. Yes, and this is the cloaca. Cloaca is the common opening, okay, for both excretion and egestion, right? So and pineal setae, we can say that pineal setae, and this is the mouth here, mouth, and maybe excretory pore. So in the same way, so it is also cylindrical body. This is the referred as anus, and here same mouth, and there is a lateral line. Right. And there may be here excretory pore and here gonopore, or the has been the reproduction, sexual reproduction, right? So why I have drawn here two diagrams, we'll try to observe these diagrams. So one is short and another one is long. So it indicates that male and female are different. So actually it is the, this one is the female and this is the male animal, right? So we'll discuss it later. See, first we'll go through the all these points, right? There are the general features or general characters of the phylum, that is Ascalmenses. They are commonly called as roundworms because body is cylindrical, or when you take it in section, when you take in section, so bodies appears like this, right? And the examples, so Ascaris, so what I have drawn here, two Ascaris, that is roundworms, commonly referred as roundworms. And even the Uchereria, we can say Uchereria and Brancafti. Uchereria Brancafti is the scientific name of this filaria worm. So you might have observed this filaria worm, filariasis, the disease which is observed in human beings, that is due to this animal only, that is Uchereria Brancafti. So that is causing a disorder called filariasis, right? So that animal is causing a disease called filariasis, elephant like legs. So which we observed, the legs are become so swelled and they are like a filler, okay, elephant like, hence Anekalu Roga. In Kannada we call that is Anekalu Roga. So that is caused by this animal only, that is filarial worm, right? And which is of course parasitic form. And one more is ancylostoma, that is hookworm, we also called hookworm, but commonly called as roundworms, right? Hooks may be present in flatworms also, right? In tapeworm and so liver fluke we may observe the hooks, but will not called commonly they are the flatworms. Body is flat, here body is cylindrical or circular when we observed in cross section, right? So this is and elongated. What is elongated? So they are free living. They are free living either in water or in the soil, moist soil, right? Aquatic means they may be in water. They found in water, or they may be terrestrial, moist soil. They may be present in the moist soil. That is what we call free living. So some are parasitic. As I gave example, this Ascaris and Uchraria are what you called. So almost the examples what I have taken, they are parasitic here. Parasitic. They may be found in the flesh of some plants, flesh part of the flower or buds or whatever parenchyma tissue. So in such a soft area of the plants, they may be found parasitic. Okay, the animals also. Some are intestinal, some are the lymph, what we call lymph vessels. They may be found in the lymph vessels. So actually, this Uchraria, what we called this worm, that is a filaria worm. So that is found in the lymph vessels of especially vertebrates, especially what we refer human beings also, right? In human beings, this Uchraria causes the filariasis, that is a disease, right? When some mosquito will carry these eggs of this one, or these will develop in that legs, especially legs lymph vessels, so which will block the lymph vessels and the swelling takes place there, right? So this is what the parasitic form in animals, right? Even Ascaris is found in the intestine, so it's a intestinal worm also. Sometimes found in the intestine, jantu hulagalu in Kannada we call, no? So usually in children we may observe this. So presently, so we are giving the medicines regularly. So once in a year or twice in a year, so it is medicated. So hence we may not observe in more cases nowadays, right? So this is the Ascaris, roundworms, right? So next one about the general characters when you take. So these are bilaterally symmetrical. The body is showing that symmetry is bilateral symmetry, because lateral line will helps to divide it two parts, right? Bilateral symmetrical. And next one, triploblastic. All are triploblastic. So these members are triploblastic, means as you know, the three germ layers, body is made by three germ layers, right? Now next one, that is pseudocoelomates. Pseudocoelomates. So previous phylum what we studied, no? So that is Platyhelminthes, that is acoelomates we called. Acoelomates, because coelom is absent there, right? So in these members we observe that pseudocoelomates, means it is a false coelom. False coelom. So there is a presence of a false coelom, right? So false coelom means that the coelom is present, but which is not lined by epithelium, not lined by epithelium. Epithelium is absent with that coelom. Epithelium is absent, which is not lined by the epithelium. Hence, we call it as a false coelom or pseudocoelomate. Body cavity is not lined by epithelium. Hence, we call it as a false coelom, or also called the animals are called pseudocoelomates. Okay, the body cavity is pseudocoelom, or coelom is like a pseudocoelom, right? Next, the organ system level of organization we observed. Organ system, remember, organ system level of organization. So little what we can consider, these are the higher animals compared to these previous phyla what we studied, because organ system level is updated here. We can advance it little bit. Organ level was observed in previous phyla, that is Platyhelminthes, organ level. Before that, tissue level. So it is a updated or advanced disease. So that is the organ system level of organization which we observed in these cases, right? Next, the alimentary canal. Alimentary canal means digestive tract. Digestive tract is also called alimentary canal, which is complete here. So that is complete means here mouth to anus. Mouth and anus are at opposite ends. Mouth is at anterior side, posterior side, anus will be there, right? So anus may be also called here cloaca, because both pores are together, right? So together, if it is there, we call it as cloaca. Okay, both opening, it's a opening for both functions like excretory as well as sometimes ejection also, right? So that is called cloaca, right? And the next one, the here muscular pharynx is present. So little what developed pharynx is developed pharynx. So advanced muscular muscle cells are also improved here. Muscular tissue is improved, right? So muscular pharynx is observed in with the elementary canal. Next one, the excretory pores. Excretory longitudinal excretory canals are there along the body, and there is a presence of excretory pores to remove the nitrogenous waste. So usually near the mouth there is a excretory pore. So usually this is what we observed here. Excretory pores are there. Excretory pores removes nitrogenous waste from the body cavity or body from the body, right? Next one, the sexes are separate here. Sexes are separate. So that is referred as dioecious. In previous phylum we observed that hermaphrodites, so there was not separate, but here sexes are separate, which is dioecious we can say, or also called unisexual. That means usually the male and female are showing the external morphological differences. Hence we observed that sexual dimorphism. So by this we can identify which is male and which is female here. So this elongated one is the female, short one is called male. Both are ascaris only, but by this observations we can, external observation we can observe that which is male and which is female we can identify. That is called sexual dimorphism. Di means two, morphism, morphology, dimorphism. Sexually they are we can observe that male, which one is male and which one is female by the length, and some other pineal setae is present with this male, such a gonophore is present with here. So by this we can observe, right? Next one, the usually as I written here, you can also take this point, females are longer than males. Females are longer than males. So this is what dioecious and unisexual also we can refer, because sexes are separate. These are not hermaphrodites, right? So hence we called dioecious, right? So that is what it is exhibiting, the sexual dimorphism, right? Next, fertilization is internal and development may be direct or indirect. So even some previous stages we appears like a very small worms, and which may be developed as a adult one, right? So indirect development with the presence of larval stages. So these are the points to be remember. So these are the general characters you should remember, and these are commonly called as roundworms. You remember roundworms or Ascomanthes, right? So these are the examples also you remember, very important. Some are parasites and some are terrestrial or what you call free living. These are said to be free living parasites, maybe plant parasite or animal parasites. So usually in vertebrates they may be present, especially in human beings also these are the parasites, endoparasites. Again we can say that endoparasites because they are found inside the body, okay? They may not be all, they may not be in the our elementary canal only. Ascaris may be in the colon, okay? So which is may be present in colon, but this filaria worm may be present in which is found in the that is lymph vessels, right? So these are the examples and these characters you should remember, okay? So in the next video with next phylum we'll see. Thank you, students.